quiet. Let's see. I don't know how long you think it's gonna last. About.
This is life, you know? Now, you know, we still win. Now it's still cold, rainy, but hey, man, who cares? They can't afford to get sick, man. You know? They're so broke, they can't afford to get sick down with them. You're dumb. You're still being surprised about this. You're not going to feel good.
Hey. A few
years. But y'all here, though.
Yeah.
So there's no excuse for you.
A couple of years ago, Jake couldn't afford to get coat.
Yeah.
You know.
Exactly. I gotta go work. I can't afford
it.
Yeah. Yeah. Jeremiah chapter 5. It says, Isaiah 21. It says, at 19. And it shall come to pass when you say, wherefore do the Lord our God all these things unto us? Then shall thou answer them, like as ye have forsaken me. Conditioning you to get ready for it. And you people are still in doubt you call yourself a prophet, somebody that can break the scripture down, you can't see this prophecy. You people are fools if you continue to follow this guy.
And not only that, but even if they can't see it and don't agree with what it is, they still not going out of their way to tell Jake not to take it.
Thank you.
They're still not warning you that, hey, it's not necessarily what you know what they're saying it is, but either way, if it comes down to it, do not take the shit.
Right.
So they're not even that. They're not even being that careful for Jake, right?
That's a very
careless, negligent attitude to have.
What happened to never trust thine enemy? You know? They sit there and call Esau the devil, but then they won't warn you against his devices.
Yeah.
Yeah. What the hell's wrong with you?
Yeah, just basically, we can't trust them. But just this time, just go ahead and trust them.
Yeah. Hey, what's the elder always mocks
you? He literally was like, Yohana said that in the same breath.
Like I was gonna say, how the elder Yashubamba always watched him, but
well, how are we gonna eat?
We gonna eat, right? Dumb, man. Just dumb dogs.
Yeah, loving the slumber. You know, what's wrong with is clout, attention, fame, and filthy lucre.
It seems like they're lacking faith.
They're not faith.
You know, because
they call themselves no cowards, and we're not cowards. But having not faith—that's a cowardly act. Think about it. That's cowardly.
Yeah.
I don't believe my God would come through for me.
Just in case, clearly said,
I think I'm gonna trust him.
Faithfulness.
Second Ezra 15, starting at the top. Behold, speak thou in the ears of my people the words of prophecy, which I will put in thy mouth, saith the Lord, and cause them to be written in paper, for they are faithful and true. Fear not the imagination of the ancients, let not the incredulity of them trouble you that speak against me. For all the unfaithful shall die in their unfaithfulness.
Doing the studies, doing the video, that's setting an example. Not going on these platforms and trying to debate the door charge, stream charge, get on there.
It's like these dudes, it's like, they trapping out the word of the Lord, man.
Yeah, yeah.
You know? Slanging it, selling it. Any way they can make some money, man.
But it don't look so bad, because it's commercial, because it looks indirect.
I got one. 2 Corinthians chapter 2 and verse 17. It says, we are not like so many others who handle God's message as it were cheap merchandise. But because the Most High hath sent us, we speak with sincerity in his presence as servants of Mashiach.
Little to put off, man. You never miss with
dare you take this job extremely serious? Because y'all bust him out shy. It's a group to say he's trusted you with this engrafted word, man, which is able to save the soul. Your duty is to what? Look at these talents. Go out on the highways and hedges and preach, man. Hey, hey, because really, hey, us, we're in a sense a beacon for really Jake, man. Because Jake that sees no hope, we're telling you, hey, man, there's a chance. Y'all Bashim Al-Shah is coming back, man. This, hey, we, you know, we may be surrounded. Hey, the end is not over, man.
We're in the same hopeless position, but we believe we have hope, and we have assurance of that hope, and evidence of that hope, which is faith. Where the faith is evidence of things, the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. This is an act of hope for us to be out here doing this.
Plus, we got the scriptures that documents all the miraculous things that the Lord did for the men who feared him.
Right. Serve him, yes.
You know, he it wasn't ashamed or confounded. The Lord didn't abandon them when they called upon him. So what makes you think that the Lord would do the same in this time?
Right.
You know? Real quick, I'm going to read the same verse. This is in the Amplified translation. 2 Corinthians 2 and 17. It says, "For we are not like many, acting like merchants, peddling the Most High's word, shortchanging and adulterating God's message, but from pure, uncompromised motives, as commissioned and sent from the Most High, we speak His message in Yahweh Shai in the sight of the Most High." We speak it from an uncompromised motive, position. All right? Esau can't buy us out. He can't drop the bag on us, and now all of a sudden, the MOTB is whatever it comes into your spirit, and you just practice it, and then you prosper, and whatever fucking bullshit you come up with just to circumvent dealing with that particular prophecy and other prophecies. Downplaying the concentration camps, saying that, you know, that's just all, you know, conspiracy.
Edomite shit.
That's Edomite shit. White people shit. They're worried because their kingdom is falling. They're worried about... Come on, man. You're playing right into the devil's hands, man. Get Jake to put their guard down and not to really, you know, pay attention.
Let me get this. Jeremiah chapter 6, verse 14. "They have healed also the hurt of the daughter of my people slightly, saying peace, peace, when there is no peace. They give a false message of peace, when nothing but destruction, lamentations, mourning, and woe is coming."
Yeah.
Now, like you said, now tell them, don't take it. Yeah, you're going to be hungry, but you're not going to starve if you're really in the good graces and you really repent. You can't, this ain't something that you can just jump in the last minute. Oh, well, yeah, okay, I'm good now. I don't know what I'm doing here, but I'm good now. No, you need to be built up. Get a proper understanding. Once you let that proper understanding, for some of you, but they'll already understand, okay, I will do whatever this, I believe God is giving me the right plan to guide me. Let me make sure I'm doing this the right way. But y'all that kind of know it, and you have the time, your attention's on it, but you're bullshit. Still got one foot in the world, one foot want to be in the truth. You know, teetering over the line and shit. Nah, man, make a decision. Could be a lukewarm.
Deuteronomy 16 and 19. "Thou shalt not rest judgment. Thou shalt not respect persons, neither take a gift. For a gift doth blind the eyes of the wise, and pervert the words of the righteous."
Yeah. Hey, if the Most High have you in the slot of being a false prophet, hey, the Lord don't like you, man.
Yeah.
Yo, he's trying to judge you.
Yeah.
The Lord don't like you on this go around. He got something against you.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know? And that's a scary thing.
Yeah, it talks about that in Jude. That, you know, these men, they were ordained unto this condemnation.
Yeah.
Men that come in unawares, crept in unawares, turn the grace of our Lord into lasciviousness, basically your own lust, your own